It's already Sunday. I've been getting increasingly anxious about Natsuki's upcoming visit. I keep telling myself that there's no reason to be nervous, but it doesn't help much. What happened to speed again? I swear the speed keeps changing on its own. I wonder if she'll act any different when it's just the two of us. I see, I move it up a bit and it's immediately mega fast. What? I don't know what's that. Meanwhile, she's been texting me a lot. We sent each other one after exchanging numbers to double check, but it turned into a conversation. She's almost a different personality on her phone, using a ton of emoji and cute language. She's also really likes complaining about things, but I kind of saw that one coming. But putting Natsuki aside, I haven't heard a thing from Sayori since she left the club earlier the other day. It's not like we text each other all the time or anything, but I've been worried about her in the back of my mind. Between that, what Sayori said and what Monika said, is it really okay for me to put Sayori's feelings aside when she might need me? I decide to visit Sayori before Natsuki comes over. Rather than asking, I simply tell her I'm coming over, much like we've done in the past. Once I reach Sayori's house, I knock on the door before entering it myself. Again, we used to play so often that we made it a habit of simply entering each other's houses like we are family. The house is quiet. The Sayori isn't anywhere on the first floor, so I assume she's up in her room. It's already strange of her not to run down and greet me. I head up to the bedroom where I finally find her. Sayori? Hi, Larry. I sit down in her room. Sayori forces a smile, but it is easy to tell that she's different. There's a minute of silence between us. You haven't come over like this in a long time, have you? Yeah, I guess you're right. It has been a long time. Not much has really changed, has it? Sayori's room is as messy as it's always been. I also recognize the same stuffed animals and wall decorations that she had for years now. If you came over more often, it wouldn't be such a mess. That's because I end up cleaning it for you. How come you suddenly wanted to come over today? Aren't you supposed to see Natsuki today? Yeah, but wait, how did you know that? Sayori had already left by the time we decided the last meeting. Monika told me. It's only natural for her to keep me informed about the festival preparations, right? Ah, that's true. But what about you? Aren't you going to be helping Monika? Of course. But I'm just helping her online. We didn't plan to meet up or anything. Ah, so it's just me and Natsuki then. Yep. Fucking neighbors are making noise again. To be on my side, it's the fucking kids that are making noise. And by noise, I mean they are fucking yelling in the corridor. Because they don't understand the fact that you don't yell next to other people's apartments. Fuck's sake. There's more silence between us. Sayori stares in a random direction. Everything about her behavior is really uncharacteristic. I finally get to the point. I just wanted to see how you were doing after you left on Friday. When something's wrong, you can't hide it from me. I know you too well. So, Sayori smiles, shaking her head. That's no good, Larry. Eh? Why can't it just be like it's always been? This is all my fault. If I didn't get so weak and accidentally express my feelings. If I didn't make that stupid mistake, then you wouldn't have been worried about me at all. You wouldn't have come over here. You wouldn't have even been thinking about me right now. But this, This is just my punishment, isn't it? I'm getting punished for being so selfish. I think that's why the world decided to have you come over today. It just wants to torture me. Sayori! I grab Sayori by the shoulders. What on earth are you saying? Are you listening to yourself right now? I know something happened to you. There's no other explanation for you to be like this. So tell me already. Until I know, I won't be able to stop thinking about it. Sayori gives me an empty smile. You really put me in a trap, Larry. But you're wrong. Nothing happened to me. I've always been like this. You're just seeing it for the first time. Seeing what? What are you talking about, Sayori? You're really going to make me say it, aren't you, Larry? I guess I have no choice this time. The thing is, I had really bad depression my whole life. Did you know that? Why do you think I'm late for school every day? Because most days I can't even find a reason to get out of bed. What reason is there to do anything when I fully know how worthless I am? Why go to school? Why eat? Why make friends? Why make other people put their energy and caring to waste by having them spend it on me? That's why I feel like. And that's why I just want to make everyone happy, without anyone worrying about me. This is the reason why I've been putting up those intros. Because this game tackles depression. This is the reason why you don't play if you're not mentally well. You don't play this game. And I can say this as a person who has and sort of is still having a depression. This is hard to read. This was really hard to read for me for the first time. Which is why this playthrough has been a perfect example of what happened to me. I gravitated towards Sayori because old friends, connection from back when. And this, I'm in shock. I can't even figure out how to respond. How is it possible that Sayori kept this from me the entire time that I've known her? Did she really want so badly for me to just not think about her? Why, Sayori? Eh? Why is it that you've never told me about this? So, I'm not saying this line. This line is fuck off. This like a fuck right off. Because if I knew, I would have done everything I could to support you. Even if there's only so much that I could do. I would have tried a little bit harder to make every day a little better for you. That's why I'm your friend. All you had to do was tell me. You don't understand at all, Larry. Why do you think I didn't tell you? Because if I told you, then you would have to waste effort caring about me instead of doing important things. I don't want to be cared about. It's bittersweet when people care about me. It feels nice sometimes, but it also feels like a bat being swung against my head. That's why I wanted so badly for you to make friends with everyone else. Helping everyone be happy together is the best thing for me. But then I discovered something else too. Seeing you make friends and get closer with everyone in the club, it feels like a spear going through my heart. So that's why. That's why I decide the world just wants to torture me. Every battle leads to nothing but hurt. You're right that I don't understand. I don't understand how your feelings at all, Sayori. But I don't need to understand. Whatever it takes for me to help you stop hurting, that's what I'll do. No, Larry. There's nothing. Nothing at all. The only thing that could have helped is if everything could be like it always was. But I was selfish. I finally showed you what a horrible person I am. Tears streaked down Sayori's face. I made you join the Leisure Club because I was selfish. I was punished by my heart hurting in a way that I couldn't understand. And now you came here and made you hurt too. I'm just weak and selfish. That's all I am. And that's why I'm going to accept these punishments. Because I deserve every last one. Without thinking, I once again grab Sayori's shoulders. This time I pull her into an tight embrace.
Larry.
Sayori, I don't care if you feel selfish. I'm really happy that you convinced me to join the club. Seeing you every day makes it worthwhile enough. If I make friends with everyone else, that is just a bonus. But please never underestimate how much I care about you. I wouldn't have it any other way.
Larry.
Sayori isn't hugging me back. Despite my arm being wrapped around her, Sayori's arms remained at her sides. She starts sobbing next to mine. I'm sorry this episode is a bit heavy. I apologize for that.
No, don't do this to me. Please don't do this. Harry, I...
Sayori barely manages to speak between her sobs. I don't know if I'm doing the right thing. But all I want is for her to know that I care. If you have it in you to call yourself selfish, then you have to let me be selfish too. No matter what it takes, I'll figure out what needs to change. I'll make these feelings go away. And if there's anything that you need me to do, then you better tell me. I'll get mad if you don't.
I don't know.
Gently, Sayori finally puts her arms around me in return. I don't know anything. It's all really scary. I don't understand any of my feelings. The only time I'm not feeling nothing is when I'm feeling pain. But your hugs are so warm, and that's really scary too. Sayori lets me go.
As she does, I let her go as well. The festival is tomorrow.
Yeah.
It's going to be fun, right?
Yeah.
How would you like for me to spend it all with you?
It's what I want. I promise.
I think that would be nice then.
Yeah. Sayori wipes her eyes. If I could spend the whole day here, I would.
Of all the days, this has to be the one when I have other plans. Maybe I should cancel.
No, don't. Please don't.
If you did that, then I really wouldn't forgive you. But it's almost time for Natsuki to meet me at my house. At the very least, do you want to come along and help out?
It would be fun. To my surprise, Sayori shakes her head. I'm so sorry. I don't know if that would be any good for me now today.
You understand, right?
It's kind of hard for me to fully understand. But I'm trying my hardest.
It's okay. Don't worry too much about it. I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
Alright.
I look forward to it. I say goodbye to Sayori and exit her house. On the way home, I find myself still feeling uneasy. But it's hard for me to keep thinking about when Natsuki is about to come over too. I think Sayori is right. I shouldn't be worrying too much, and we're definitely going to have a great time tomorrow. I should just focus on what's ahead of me.